So I am in between your lunch and you. So I will conclude very quickly. I am going to share you my global experience with the industrial regulations, especially related to wastewater treatment plant. And what I feel that when we see the global regulation related to chemical wastewater discharge standards, then India standard need to align with the international standards. So my experience in last 23 years, I worked with Shell, I worked with Unilever, and right now I am working with UPL. So these all are the global company, and I get chance to travel globally and see the standards of various country. And my experience is that several regulations are related to environment which need to be aligned with the international standards. Now here I shall cover these topics, deep sea discharge standards, quints, CEPI, ZLD, and then also we will talk very quickly that what new technology and the sustainability related things we are working in industry. So here the summary is this, that in morning session, I like Florian from McKinsey. He told that the regulations are, some of the regulations are helpful, some of regulations are misguided, and some of regulations are panicky. And I think our regulations in India also, if we see, then this deep sea discharge standard, I can say it is a misguided regulation. Quints also misguided. CEPI is a panicky, under panicky. And ZLD is also a misguided regulations. But the regulation related to sustainability, where we need to embed sustainability into our business, related to the wastewater treatment which need to be discharged in river, that I feel those are very helpful and good regulations. Now before going to the regulation, I think let me share this chart. What I want to show you that in India, if we see the general condition, then one is the manufacturing. So in manufacturing, especially export of chemical, we are lower. So we are lower globally to the other country, especially the small country like Switzerland, who export nearly $100 billion chemical, but our export is just $41 billion. So we are lower in export. If you see the CO2 emission, then in CO2 emission also, we are lower than the other country. If you see the ecological footprint, there also, our footprint is lower than the rest of several countries, advanced and the developed countries. But if you see the standards, which I have shown here, so our standards for the wastewater treatments are very stringent as compared to other countries like Turkey, USA, Switzerland, and even the Colombia also, our standards are very, very stringent. So what I want to show you that our manufacturing is lower, our CO2 emission is lower, our ecological footprint is lower in India, but we are heading toward a impractical and stringent regulation which need to be aligned with the international standards. And if you see all these data, then one thing is very clear that we are not part of a global environment problem. But yes, we want to be part of solution. Now this is the standard which I want to show you and which I told that our deep sea discharge standard in India is a misguided regulation. And you can see here, I have compared with the US EPA regulation. So in US, they have a very good deep sea discharge system. And in our India also, we have very good deep sea discharge system. I think most system, if you go in US, they are also 10 kilometers inside the sea. And in our deep sea discharge system, In Gujarat, that is also 10 kilometers inside sea. But in regulation, if you see, for two industries, I have given the example, pesticide and pharma, so clearly difference is there. So one important parameter, COD, if you see, then as per our standard, we allow to discharge maximum 250 ppm COD, whereas in USA, it is nearly 4,000 ppm COD. And for pharma industry, they allow up to 1,675 ppm COD. So several things like COD, BOD, TSS, ammonical nitrogen, here the comparison is, and it's very clearly that our standard related to deep sea discharge is not a practical. Another important point I want to tell you that if you see our standard related to effluent treatment, this COD 250 ppm is for the river discharge also, for the on-land discharge also, and for deep sea discharge also. So all cannot be the same. But right now, our standard is like this, and that need to be aligned with the US-EPA standard. Then this is the second important thing, quints. In beginning of this year, Central Pollution Control Board came out with the proposed standard, a comprehensive industrial standard for the pesticide industry. And here you can see that while I was talking that already our standards are stringent, but in beginning of 2019, CPCB brought this standard even to tighter more. And COD instead of 250, they have proposed 150 ppm. BOD instead of 100 ppm, 30 ppm. Arsenic instead of 0.2 ppm, 0.1 ppm. And the most difficult and most impractical thing is that the effluent discharge, they are going to restrict that it should be only 220 liter per ton. Whereas at this moment of time, average effluent discharge, if you see in pesticide industry, our experience at UPL is nearly 3,000 cubic meter per ton. So 220 liter per ton is virtually impractical, or you have to go for the ZLD. So I think thanks to ICC that we represented various representation in the CPCB and ministry, finally this standard is on hold. But later on, let us see what happens. Then CEPI. So CEPI I can consider is under the category of a panic standard, which is creating a panic inside the industry. And you can see that at the bottom, this was came out, means launched by Jairam Ramesh during UPA government in 2009. And at that time, this CEPI, which is a comprehensive environmental pollution index, it was brought with the aim that we will just give an alarm to the industry that if index is higher, then take certain measures. But now, when the NGT gave verdict recently on 10th of July, where NGT told that there should be no further industrial activity, no expansion in CEPI area, then the entire industry came in panic. And now some modification happened. But what right now regulation is saying that in those areas where the CEPI index is greater than 60, in all EC, they are putting condition zero liquid discharge. So now they have made ZLD mandatory in those areas where CEPI index is more than 60. And at this moment of time, most of chemical get manufactured in Gujarat and Maharashtra. And in all those areas, at this moment of time, CEPI index is greater than 60. So it means they are going to implement zero liquid discharge. Now, as far as zero liquid discharge is concerned, here also, if you see, which is getting imposed by CEPI, this is not an environment-friendly regulations. And I have given a comparison, where one comparison is, if you want to meet the discharge standard, then what will be the power consumption, CO2 emissions, solid waste generation, chemical consumption, capital cost and operating cost? And the other is the when ZLD will be there, then how much? And what this study is showing for 2.5 MLD wastewater treatment plant, that the power consumption in ZLD is 4 times higher. CO2 emission, which is now a global problem, CO2 emission is 4 times higher in ZLD. Solid waste generation is 2 times higher. Chemical consumption is 2 times higher in ZLD. And capital cost 2.5 times higher. And operating cost is 3 times higher in ZLD. So with this study, what we want to show that ZLD is not an environment-friendly option, but still now it is get imposed in the CEPI area. Now, after this is the sum of the cases where the new technology we have implemented at UPL to meet the our discharge standards. And I think why I want to show at last this, because we are not against the good regulation. We are not against the environment. We want to protect. And I think in India, if you see, chemical industry is highly regulated and they are doing excellent work. But the only point is that the regulation must be aligned with the international standards and must be practical. So here these three technology, which first time we have implemented in chemical industry, our experience is very good with a Scaleban technology, Volute technology, OH radical technology, and forward osmosis technology. Right now we have a very less time, so I will not go on explaining all this. Later on, if anyone is interested, I can share this case study. But this is very good for the chemical industry. And this is the last slide which I want to show you, that at UPL we have adopted a structured approach towards sustainability. And in our sustainability, we have included a triple bottom line. So environment, economic and social, all the aspects has been integrated in our sustainability agenda. Then we have also launched an exclusive website on sustainability. So you can go on the sustainabilityuplonline.com and you can find a lot of things which we are doing related to sustainability. Regularly we are publishing the sustainability report every year, and the DJSI and FTSE index, our score is very high this year as compared to last year. So I think this is the way how we have integrated sustainability in our operation. So I think with this, I shall conclude my lecture and with the message that we are for the sustainability, we are for the environment, but only thing is that those regulations which are misguided or who are creating panic inside industry, our request from the government is, especially from MOEF and CPCB, that they should look into this and they should align this standard with the international standards. Thank you.